Greetings. We are all here today for three reasons: to mourn a death, to celebrate a life, and to proclaim a resurrection. When we were baptized in Christ Jesus, we were baptized into his death. We were buried with him by his baptism into death, so that as he was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we were united with Christ in his death, we will certainly be united with him in his resurrection. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our sister Bobby. We thank you for giving her to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us your aid so that we may see in death the gate to eternal life, that we may continue our course on earth in confidence until, by your call, we are reunited with those who have gone before us. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We will now sing the hymn, Blessed Assurance.
In our hearts, we thought of you with love today, but that is nothing new. We thought about you yesterday and days before that too. We think of you in silence. We often speak your name. Now all we have is memories and your picture in a frame. Your memory is our keepsake with which we'll never part. God has you in his keeping. We have you in our heart.
Psalm 121. I lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore.
Roberta Marie Kondert. Roberta Bobby, 78, Rochester, Minnesota, passed away unexpectedly in her home January 1st, 2022. Bobby was born July 13, 1943 in Faribault, Minnesota, to Robert Marie Berg. Bobby grew up in Rochester and graduated from Rochester John Marshall in 1961. She then graduated from Rochester Junior College in 1963. Most of Bobby's working career was as a medical secretary in clinical microbiology at Mayo Clinic until her retirement in 2001. Bobby had a zest for life. She loved to spend time with family, whether it be celebrations, holidays, or just to be together. Bobby loved to cook for the family, travel, play cards, go antiquing, play bingo at the casino, and just recently completed 82 puzzles that she had posted on Facebook. The kindness and generosity that Bobby showed towards others was undeniably her greatest gift, and she will be missed by all who have been blessed to have known her. Bobby is survived by her husband, Hans Kondert, children, Scott, Mary Springer, and Kirsten Dan Wessel, stepchildren Michael Kondert and Tony Kondert, grandchildren Megan Sean Cooney, Robert Springer, and Trevor Ashley Springer, step-grandchildren Aaron Courtney Hinton, Matt Tara Wessel, Megan Doug Marjoram, and Mara Wessel, great-grandchildren Jameson and Ronan Cooney, step-great-grandchildren Parker Peyton and Hudson Wessel, Charlie Aubrey and Brinley Marjoram, sister Rebecca Arnold Bumgars, and nieces Molly Feely, Kate Bumgars, Andy Bowers, and great-niece and nephew Georgia and Luke. Bobby was preceded in death by her parents, Robert and Marie Tutzberg. Bobby, wife, mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, sister, aunt, friend, angel. All of us here today have been so blessed to have Bobby in our lives. Bobby leaves a legacy of wonderful memories that will live on in all our hearts and will be carried on through the years with all of us that she has touched. Bobby had so many passions, a passion for her family, a passion for experiencing life to its fullest, a passion for traveling the world, going to Germany to meet all of Hans's family, a passion for not being afraid to learn new things, Facebook, Instagram, a passion for embracing retirement and enjoying it to the fullest. Bobby was busier than ever when she worked. Her calendar was full, playing cards twice a week, swimming at the health club, going out to eat with Hans, going out to eat with family and friends, taking trips to California, Arizona, Nevada, Sioux Falls, South Dakota, the Twin Cities, to see friends and family. We would joke as we would say, let's see if this works with Bobby's schedule. Of course, Bobby also loved to entertain for the holidays, especially Thanksgiving and Easter. Bobby would prepare all the usual meal fixings, including her famous scalloped corn, extra crispy, pecan tassies and apple pie, all of the family's favorites. Along with all the roles that Bobby had through the years, a more recent and joyful surprise was when she was discovered as Miss Buka. So as the story goes, Bobby's grandson, Robert, was going to school in Thousand Oaks, California. Robert was going with a group of friends to the Italian restaurant, Buca di Beppo. Robert noticed this picture on the wall and thought, gosh, that looks like my grandma Bobby. Rob took a picture, sent it to Bobby, and sure enough, it was Bobby's graduation picture that the restaurant used and titled it Miss Buca. To Bobby's delight, the family was now on a mission to visit as many Bucas as we could, enjoy the food, and search for her picture. Las Vegas, Nevada, Salt Lake City, Utah, Thousand Oaks, California, Maple Grove, Minnesota, St. Paul, Minnesota, we have found Bobby's picture and created such great memories. Bobby also loved collecting angels that she loved. For many Christmases, we would give Bobby an angel. Bobby truly was an angel, herself in life and now in death. We will all miss you, Mom. We love you.
I will see you again. The sun shall rise and sure to set. Her time has come, have no regret. Her life she lived, we sure all know. A better place she has to go. Rejoice today, it's at an end, and she will see us once again.
Revelation 21, 1 through 4. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the old heaven and the old earth had disappeared, and the sea was also gone. And I saw the holy city, the Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven like a bride beautifully dressed for her husband. I heard a loud shout from the throne saying, "Look, God's home is now among his people. He will live with them, and they will be with his people. God himself will be with them also. He will wipe every tear from their eyes, and there will be no more death, or sorrow, or crying, or pain. All these things are gone forever."
Hi. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Kate. I'm Bobby's niece. For the past 8 years, my kids and I have called Bobby Great Aunt Bobby. Now, there's two reasons why we call her Great Aunt Bobby. One, she's a pretty great aunt. And two, because after much debate, internet searches, several phone calls, more internet searching, Bobby and I determined the lineage and names for all of our family during one of our infamous card games. See, and this is what Great Aunt Bobby and I would be doing during our many hours of playing cards together. Our tradition began first when we started playing with Grandma Berg. The games were full of laughter, arguing about the rules, and watching Grandma's mistakes. Was Grandma really cheating? Probably not, but her mistakes always favored her scoring extra points. Bobby and I started to really get to know each other during Grandma's turns. See, the older Grandma got, the longer her turns got. And we would spend time catching up and talking. And did Grandma actually cheat? Probably not. But her extra picking up extra cards or discards, she would adamantly deny it. After Grandma passed away, we made sure to keep the card game alive. The tradition of Grandma's rules were the purest crazy canasta rules handed down through generations. Every time I came to Rochester, my first phone call, outside of my mom, my dad, and my sister, was to Bobby. I got to get my game set up. You know, her schedule was always packed, so I had to be sure she could squeeze me in. The windows of opportunities were narrow. She had several regular card games on the go, and even though I only passed through every so often, her regular games always had priority. And lest we forget about her trips to the casinos, we would be sneaking in last-minute games hours before she left. During the time we played cards together, she would catch me up on her current puzzles, the latest adventures. Whether she was road tripping with Hans in a car he had to drive, going with a charter group to a casino, or the latest hotel room she was comped in Laughlin, she always led the conversation. Most of the time we talked about her family. She beamed talking about everyone and dove into explanations about their newest adventures. Where Scott was traveling to next, or what crazy new boxing class Kirsten was doing, Megan's newest additions and what do you buy kids these days, Robert's new job and Trevor's new bride. There was never a dull moment or an awkward silence. Those were always filled with, let's have another cookie. And her response, oh, maybe just one more. The time I got to spend with Bobby playing cards was more than just a card game. I cherished the time playing with her. I learned so much about her that I missed as a child growing up. As the more shy daughter, Bobby came out of her shell and kept a social calendar that rivaled a teenager. Her phone skills may not have been that proficient, but it greatly improved during our card games. I helped link her Instagram and her Facebook so she could, and we practiced FaceTiming so she could stay connected while I traveled. Sometimes she would get confused about the FaceTime audio button and the FaceTime video button, but we would just chuckle and try another day. The last time I chatted with Bobby was right before Christmas. She FaceTimed me and we spoke for about 35 minutes, mostly about her plans for Easter and how she and Hans had decided to move everything out of the living room so there would be more room for everyone to sit and not be so tightly squeezed into the dining room. Her holiday meals were tradition. From the Rose Point china to the scallop corn, Bobby's meals were consistent and delicious. I missed the last Thanksgiving and Christmas, but Easter was on the books and my seat was saved at her table. There was always room at Bobby's table for family and friends. Whether it was the card table or Thanksgiving dinner table, she made everyone feel welcome. I will miss my cards game with Bobby, but not for the whomping she could lay down on me, but the conversations. Always pleasant, and she never wavered in her friendship or her loyalty. We had hours upon hours of joyous time together, laughing and debating. She was a happy and kind person that made my trips home even more enjoyable because I knew Bobby was going to be there to play. We will all miss her for different reasons, as a mother, a grandmother, a sister, a wife, a friend, a card game partner, and for me, a great aunt.
Do not stand by my grave and weep. I am not there. I do not sleep. I am a thousand winds that blow. I am the diamond glints on snow. I am the sun on ripened grain. I am the gentle autumn rain. When you awaken in the morning's hush, I am the swift, uplifting rush of quiet birds in circled flight. I am the soft stars that shine at night. Do not stand at my grave and cry. I am not there. I did not die.
John 14, 1 through 6. Don't be troubled. You trust God, now trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's home, and I'm going to prepare a place for you. If this were not so, I would tell you plainly. When everything is ready, I will come and get you, so that you will always be with me where I am, and you know where I'm going and how to get there. No, we don't know, Lord, Thomas said. We haven't any idea where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus told him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me.
Please rise as we read the Lord's Prayer. In unison, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Bobby. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. We will now sing, I Was There to Hear Your Morning Cry. Thank you. What a legacy. What a life. I invite each of you to keep Bobby's name alive in your hearts. We were all touched by her presence, and we are better because of that. Committal at the cemetery will follow this ceremony for immediate family only, and then lunch will follow the committal here at the funeral home right next door. Thank you all for being here and making Bobby's life so meaningful. Blessings to you all.